For today, it will be more of the joy of doing research that you're going to feel relative to the project that we implemented. So magandang umaga po sa ating lahat.
Magandang
umaga po. Kaya nga, I will be the one facilitating, so there will be more of me in the next few hours until the afternoon. But I hope that I could engage you with the many things that we discovered with the National Catechetical Study. Okay? So I think many of you are familiar with what had happened since last year. And so I hope that you're going to see the difference now. Although, it should be clear right from the start that we have not had, we have yet to process, and brace yourself, for more than 28,000 catechist respondents. Wow. 28,000. More than. Dumadating pa yung iba. We only processed 17,000. And so ngayon po, we're going to share with you the output of the 17,000 catechist respondents and the 287 catechetical directors and the coordinators' output. Okay? So, ibig sabihin, iba ng istorya, hindi katulad ng isang taon, noong 2016, na less than 1,000 lang ang nakuha naming respondents. Tapos, noong 2017, nakiusap kami sa lahat. Parang awa nyo na, para sa simbahan, gumalaw tayong lahat. Kasi sabi talaga sa amin, nila Bishop, nila Mother Jen, sabi sa amin, imposible makakuha kayo ng mga respondents dyan. Sabi ko, by the grace of God and through the catechetical director, siguro we could get more, right? And why is it important? Kasi we want to get the bigger picture of the catechetical ministry in the country. And so, unahin ko siguro pasasalamat, no? Kasi parang sinummarize po ni Bishop Ambo lahat ng sasabihin po namin today. Okay, so, that is the message of the day, right? To become servant leadership, because that was the discovery finding of the National Catechetical Study. Anyway, you're going to see that. So today, I think first things first. So before the presentations, do you know what will happen today? Hindi ba? Hindi niyo po alam. Kasi hindi pa namin nabibigay sa inyo ang inyong kit. So we develop a module. This means you're going to work, right? So we have a module that we develop for everyone so that you could see the basic arguments of each paper. Of each presentation. So ngayon, hindi na to basta-basta ano lang presentation. Ano na to, may mga argument na to. And I'm going to challenge everyone to think about the pastoral implications of our data. Okay? Yung pong gagawin natin mamayang hapon. But for now, we are going to distribute the module. And as soon as the modules were distributed, I'm going to give you another gift. Kasi this is really something that we're excited to do. Why? Alam niyo po, pag-researcher ka dito sa bansang ito, parang hindi ka naman talaga pinapansin eh. Naintindihan niyo po ba? Sa kongreso natin, maraming batas, walang research. Okay? Sa pastoral planning po natin, I do not know if you are clear with it, hindi nag-research, nagpa-plan lang. Sa buhay natin, lahat nagpa-plan lang, wala nag-research. Kaya hindi mo ma-assess kung ano nangyayari, right? This time, we're very thankful to Lisander and the team. When I received the letter stating something like, Dear Dr. Batan, Dear Yayan, right? We would like to invite you to be one of the speakers and the trainers ng certificate program. Sabi ko, wow! Alam niyo po, I never thought that one day I will be doing this because although I tried, lalabas ko na istorya ko, ha? I tried to become a priest, right? 4 times, but I was rejected by 4 seminaries, right? When I was younger. But God has a beautiful, you know, plan for everyone. So, Father, okay lang yan. Yan ang plan ng Panginoon, no? Para sa atin. So, anyway, the point is, when I was asked to lead this catechetical, I'm a sociologist. So, what I do is sociology of youth, children, and work. So, gusto ko yung mga issue ng mga ng bayan, right? Issue ng simbahan, natatakot ako. Okay? So ngayon, nung Friday I was with the conference of catechesis and religious education and we did share some of the findings there. I was really empowered kasi sabi ko, oh my God, ang daming problema ng simbahan, right? And kailangan tong intindihin with a research perspective, with the joy of research. And so today, did you see the ano na po, the modules, right? So the module, ibig lang sabihin din, nandiyan yung schedule natin. First half, we're going to talk about the findings. Second half, we're going to have the workshop. And the workshop, we will leave it to you. I'll be there to ano, to give you. But another gift that we would like to give is this one. We designed a specific logo for the National Catechetical Study. Okay? And this is what the Bishop Bobet approved, right? So, naintindihan niyo po siguro, no? Etche with Catechetical Ministry. And I hope you're going to remember us with that pin. And today, para maganda po yung input, kindly wear it even for today, right? So the logo represents the lens. Okay? Lens. Lente. Sa aming mga researcher po, mahalaga po ang lente. Okay? Ibig sabihin, we cannot see everything, but we need a lens so we could see further or deeply into something, right? And what we were meant to look at is this one. Take note that we are only problematizing here catechetical ministry. We were not asked to problematize religious education, because probably if we problematize religious education, the religious landscape in the Philippines, it will take up 20 years before we understand it, right? So, ang hiling lang po sa amin ng ECHE is to understand the concept of catechetical ministry relative to the many indicators that we're going to tell you. Now, it has run for about 2 years now and we're about to finish thanks to the data. We're still processing some, but July will be a big day because we will be asked for a 20-minute presentation before the Catholic Bishops Conference of the Philippines. So we will be the voice of the catechetical ministry and catechetical leaders and the catechists for that 20 minutes. So please pray for us. So hand in hand, we're looking at the catechetical ministry with CBCP ECHE relative to the symbolism of the dove, which in our view, nung nag-uusap-usap kami, talagang malinaw na yung pagdadala ng pananampalataya sa iba't ibang parokya, through the guidance of the Holy Spirit. Yun po yung na-feel namin dun sa proseso. And so, the colors are indicative of the church, which is yellow and black. And the green is a representation of our research ideas. Okay? So, do you have the pin now?
Yes.
Do you have the module?
Yes.
Okay, I think we could go now, right? So, pwede na. We could move on. So, thank you very much for this opportunity. We will not stop thanking. Kasi sabi ko nga, kauna na ang sinabi ko dun sa last, yun dun sa conference last week was, you know what? If you're thinking that you will be learning from us because we were tasked, commissioned by CBCP ECHE to do this, I tell you, it's more than that for the team because it has been a transformative experience for us. Transformative because we never realized that we will be dealing with catechists and catechetical directors where, nako, grabe, it challenges the way you view your faith, it challenges the way you think about life. Kung malungkot ka, tingin ko, tingnan mo lang yung catechetical study data para mapahiya ka, right? Oo. Later, you're going to see what I meant by that. But for now, let's start with the first presentation, which is this one. So I'm using my laptop now kasi masyado siyang malaki. So I am going to challenge everyone kasi challenge in a sense, good challenge. In a sense na the problem with researchers and the problem with academics, I think, is that we thought that we are the most noble and the most learned, no? But there's one thing that they do not do, which is to share the data. Right? I mean, salita ka ng salita dyan. Anong data mo? Anong basis mo? Right? Okay, ganito. As promised, we're changing the landscape. This National Catechetical Study is not an academic research only. It should be done with scientific, you know, dimension. And we're good with that. Alam namin yan, right? But what we problematize is the pastoral dimension of the study. Kasi we're not doing this for our sake, for our being, you know, intellectuals or what. We're doing this to better, we hope, the catechetical ministry. So medyo mabigat yung pastoral challenge nung study. So I was asking earlier, may dala ba kayong USB? Kasi ibibigay namin sa inyo kung anong meron kami, 1.2 gig siya. We will be sharing with you everything from the literature to the presentations to the descriptives. Raw siya, pero kung kaya niyong basahin yung Excel, which we generated from our SPSS, Statistical Packages for Social Science Analysis, makikita niyo siya. We already prepared sample demographics for each ecclesiastical territory. We already prepared national demographics for the 17,000. We processed it so that you could see the names of the catechists, your catechists, and you could check it out. Kung sino ang nag-respond at hindi, right? So, we did it. However, it's never perfect. Why? Because around, from the 17,000, about, I would say about 2,000 did not indicate where they belong to. We have no way to doing it, right? Except to declare it that it's null and void. However, the raw data we maintain so you could see the names probably of those part of your analysis. But please, do not tell us na, huy, taga ano siya? We cannot do that anymore kasi we cannot revert the coding process. But in any case, we prepared everything. The modules, you will have a part of it because I designed it personally for your pastoral planning later. So I hope that you're going to use it for your pastoral planning, not only in catechetical ministry, but also in other ministries. Bottom line, this is the way to share knowledge. And we're happy to be given the chance to share knowledge so that we could transfer the research technology. Later, I'm going to talk about how to transfer the research technology than you just waiting for us evolve and run the data. We don't like that. We want you to be engaged in your respective data. But before the workshop, let's just have a feel of what the results of the national research, national catechetical study is. So we have first the empirical findings, the overview. I hope I'm going to okay. There you go. Are you feeling good?
Yes.
Medyo ano to, medyo seryoso to ng konti, pero we'll make it fun. Okay? We'll make it fun. Okay. So, this is the National Catechetical Study. Dati tinatawag namin 2016, but you know what? It ran for 2 years, and so it should not be 2016. Kasi yung reference, ang totoo nito, nagsimula ang research study na walang kumapansin. Right? The usual, parang pag-ibig eh. You have to perk up the interest. Anyway, may hugot. Nawalan po ako ng relasyon dahil dito sa study. Ibubuhos ko na. Alam mo po, wala po, alam to ni Doc Jo. Alam po na wala po akong pakialam dito sa nangyayari dito. Wala po akong alam. As in, wala akong kinalaman dito. Kasi iba nga po yung mundong ginagalawan ko. 2 taon na po akong nagkakatikista study. So, I expect that we will be producing books out of this. And so, after noon, move on na ako. Pwede po ba? Okay? Move on tayo. Okay, so, this is the National Catechetical Study, some empirical findings and findings. Just an overview. Just an overview. And so, to give the first part of the presentation, I am very pleased to introduce to you Dr. Joanne Trosha. Doctor?
Magandang umaga po sa ating lahat.
Good morning.
Parang marami na rin ang mga ilang beses na tayo nagkita, no? May mga ilang beses na rin tayo nagkita. We started NCS 2016 at the outset when we asked the help of some catechetical ministers during the AMCM Davao. Pwede po bang makita kung sino ang naandun? You helped us a lot in developing the final survey questionnaire. Maraming salamat po. Tapos sumunod noon, bago yung Cebu, nagkita-kita kami ng mga kaparian naman natin sa Batangas. Escape Batangas. Pwede po bang makita ang mga nandun? Si Father Timex lagi talagang present yan, no? Father Peter, Father Chuck. Pagkatapos doon, AMCM, Cebu. Pwede po bang makita yung nasa... And also the NACFIL, National National Association of Catechists in the Philippines, gathering dito po sa Lasal. Ayan, maraming beses nyo na pala kaming narinig, no? Maraming beses na tayong naghuntahan. Now, what is new about this presentation now? Siguro po, balikan lang natin para dun sa ngayon lang po, ngayon lang nakadalo sa ganitong presentation, pwede natin makita ang kamay. Ayan, welcome to the presentation of NCS 2016-2018. Pero bago yan, pwede pang malaman sino ang galing ng Mindanao? Meron ba? Maayong pag-abot din sa Lasal. I'm from Gensan, Diocese of Marbel. Sino po ang galing Visayas? Yehey! Daghang salamat! Gipanganak ko sa Cebu, no? Tagaluzon po, North, North. Meron bang from way up Batanes? South naman, South. So North, South, Central, NCR. Okay, talagang represented ang buong Pilipinas. Ito po ngayon ang National Catechetical Study 2016, Empirical Findings and Pastoral Insights. Some empirical findings, as what has been mentioned by Doc Yayet, we are awaiting about 10,000 more to be encoded and processed. But we have already processed around 17,000 responses, no? From 17,000 respondents. So, all in all po, baka mga 30 to 31,000 tayong lahat. So, maraming salamat. So, for this presentation, we'll be looking into, at least reviewing for some of you, the context. And we will be sharing to you some empirical findings and some pastoral insights. Kumusta ang mga katikista? Kumusta ang ating mga responses? Ano ngayon ang kinalaman nito sa ating ginagawa sa simbahan? So, we would like to, in this presentation, we will be led into examining some partial census and interview data to describe the current state of the Philippine Catechetical Ministry, and results suggest that the Catechetical Ministry in the Philippines may be characterized by the following. Pwede niyong sabihin, tama ba yan, mali ba yan, at least sa inyong diocese, no? Demographically, Catechetical Ministry is being carried out by mostly older, lay-educated women volunteers, not even full-time, and receiving minimal transportation support. Okay. Nasa data natin, talagang sinasabi na, no? Hindi lang natin sinasabi basta, nandun talaga based sa research. Half of the catechist respondents reported having underwent formal training. When we say formal, those who have undergone certificate course, diploma course, at least a bachelor's degree, no? So half of them have undergone formal formation. But ongoing formation appears to be evident across dioceses. So meaning, may mga ongoing formation naman. Pero mamaya makikita natin kumusta ba yung estado ng formation nila. Okay. Teaching catechism seems to focus more on children in public schools. So ang ating catechetical ministry is children catechesis, mostly in public schools. And where contents are mostly on fundamentals of faith and sacraments. No, yun ang itinuturo. Catechist respondents remain using traditional lecture mode. Although tinanong natin, no, ano-ano yung mga lecture, ano-ano yung mga strategies na ginagamit, ito po yung lumabas sa findings natin. They remain using traditional lecture mode, although most preferred technique is storytelling. Okay? And catechist respondents reported observing high level of religious and sacramental practices. Mamaya pag dinatalya natin, makikita nyo ano ba yung mga religious practices na yan, no? Spiritual practices. High moral disposition. Buti na lang ganyan ang lumabas. Kasi kung hindi, matatakot tayo, hindi ba? On Catholic Church stance, and with relative high level of reported happiness, commitment, satisfaction in life. Okay. Yan yung sinasabi ng data, masaya tayo. Ang tanong, bakit sila masaya? Diba? Bakit sila satisfied? Bakit sila happy? Dahil ba sa minimal lang na transportation allowance? No? Bakit? So yun yung titingnan ng data natin. Di ba po? Masarap pag-usapan. So, our NCS 2016-2018 argues on some relevant pastoral insights on how CM may be enhanced relative to the current demographic landscape of teaching catechism in the country and the elements of, katulad ng sabi ni Doc Yayat kanina, actually yung maghapon natin ngayon was summarized by Bishop Ambo this morning when he talked about servant leadership. That is faith-based service observed as a social-spiritual dynamic of catechetical practice among catechist respondents. Note that we mention social-spiritual, not just spiritual. Right? So, merong ibang mga social factors na pag-uusapan natin. Alright, so ano itong project na to? A review for some. There have been two studies in the past already. Anchored from, of course, Archbishop Legazpi's Passion for Catechesis, no? Yung kanyang vision noon, yung struggle, yung crisis, captured in that book, this book by Archbishop Legazpi titled Passion for Catechesis, a collection of catechetical talks and articles. So yung ating ginagawa ngayon, lahat yan, makikita natin no, from Catechesi Tradende, alam po natin yung ating mga church documents, right? Sinulat ni Archbishop, nagkaroon po ngayon ng dalawang pag-aaral in the past. One in 1979 and one in 1988. Beautiful surveys responded by some. However, according to this book, there is a need to acquire an updated picture of the catechetical situation in the Philippines as the data were partial, incomplete, and not validated. 1988 po yan. Ilang taon na ang nagdaan? Almost 30 years, almost 30 years tayo nag-respond, ano po. Pero, kung babasahin po natin iyan, wala actually pagbabago dun sa mga tanong, ganun pa rin. Pero baka may pagbabago na sa kontekstong ginagalawan natin, right? So there is a need, hence this study. So the main objective is just to describe, pero magugulat po tayo ang dami pong narating ng description na to. Describe the present state of the Philippine Catechetical Ministry, that is to determine the demographic profile of the Filipino catechists and catechetical leaders or catechetical directors and coordinators. And from here on, assessing the needs of Filipino catechists. Kasi po, di ba minsan madalas sa experience natin, gumagawa tayo ng program, gumagawa tayo ng project sa catechetical ministry, pero nakikita pa talaga natin, totoong pangangailangan ba ito? So ang ating po ngayong study will help support our planning. Yung ating planning now will be informed by the data that we have gathered from the catechists mismo and from yourselves. Okay, so nabanggit na po ito ni Doc Yayat kanina, nabanggit na rin ni Sister Rhea. We have been consulting these people, no? Wonderful people, the ECHA leadership headed by Bishop Mariari, Monsignor Cherry, Sister Jess and Hinko, of course, Father Dex, maraming salamat, nandito siya ngayon, Father Putsu, and Dr. Linda Tacorda, who did the two surveys po. No po? And of course, we are assisted by our research assistant. Si Ace po ay gagraduate na sa June 4 ng sociology. Si Joan naman, tapos na ng sociology from UST. Okay. Alright. Paano natin ito ginawa? No? So, balikan lang natin at para at least alam nyo kung paano ginawa para baka pwede nyong gayahin na rin sa inyong parokya. Matututo tayo dito. Giving back the microphone to Doc Yaya.
Gusto nyo bang palakpakan si Sir? Kasi yun lang talagang gusto mangyari natin dito. Ano? Okay. So, research methodology. I just would like to just explain this because there's no such research with good insights if there is no sound methodology. Okay? So, minsan, yun yung problema ng lahat sa atin. We thought we have the best idea, especially for the thesis and dissertation. But no, I have to look into the methodology. I'm a methodologist. So, medyo, ito yung medyo clearing na clear sa akin. When Dr. Linda Tacorda went to our office, and she saw how organized our questionnaires are. Imagine, about 27,000 questionnaires in my office, but I have to be able to have a random check
tama ba yung encoding na to and everything, so we are all organized. So I'm happy to share with you again the methodology. Okay, so the research space that we chose are 17 ecclesiastical provinces and 86 ecclesiastical territories. Remember that we are not problematizing the parishes. Okay, it's a national study. So we have to be clear what research space we're going to work at. And I do not know if there was ever a study that problematizes ecclesiastical provinces. We are starting to realize it's the most important dimension of how Filipino church is organized. Pwede kayo magkaroon ng project through the ecclesiastical provinces. And we will explain to you why. Ecclesiastical territories, you know that. Diocese, archdiocese, prelature, ordinary. Dioceses and parishes are incorporated into that. Now, our general orientation is both academic. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm going to give you everything here. So please do not worry. Everything will be given to you. 1.2 gig. Okay? 1.2 gig. Nakita niyo po yung libro kanina? I will be giving you copies of those books electronically. So, depende na sa inyo kung gusto niyo i-print out. But, kaya siya malaki kasi what we did is we come scan the book. Why? Because it's not available anymore. You cannot even buy it anymore, right? So you will have copies of the old study, the two books produced by Echeri and Eche, plus the book of Archbishop. Okay? So, it's a commission research, meaning we do not have too much... Kumbaga, when you say it's commission, there is a specific logic to it. Okay? So you cannot be as open and horrible in discovering things and asking questions. Hindi pwede yun, kasi commission research kami. So we were guided. Okay? Is that a limitation? I don't think so. It's actually a good thing because we know what we want to talk about. Funding, this is very, very important. CBCP Eche, thank you to everyone kasi you were able to give us 174,000 only. Right? Okay? So but we need more. RC said that the USC Research Center for Social Sciences and Education, the University of Santo Tomas, was so good, and I'm going to repeat, hi Father, over and over again. We were paid, some of our load were paid because of this project, which is tantamount to about 2 million pesos for the entire year. Research sites. There are some of you who are so beautiful and so good, na pagpupunta kami, you make it sure that we have the best food ever and the best accommodation. So thank you. Isasama namin yung sa computation para alam natin kung magkano nagastos natin sa studying ito. Design. The design is not explanatory. Remember, it's not explanatory. Meaning, we just want to explore and describe. So for explanatory purposes, you would have to do some kind of inferential statistics. And so, huwag muna yun. Ano muna, exploratory muna. No, we will not do principal component analysis or regression analysis in using the data. But we could, but not now, okay? It's just exploratory descriptive. The approaches is mixed methods. So we have both quantitative and qualitative. So we have the interviews, focus groups, and we have the survey. Tatlo lang, napakasimple lang. Survey, interview, and focus group discussion. What is the focus of analysis? The focus of analysis is to do some kind of a census. And this is very ideal, no? May problema yata si Yayet, no? Designing it as a census. That's why we did not sample any ecclesiastical province. Meaning, we're not asking 5 respondents from you. Kasi ganun yung iba, di ba? Mga study, katulad ng SWS, they only have 1,200, 1,400, because it's too costly. Ako, very idea. You know what? We have the catechetical directors, palagi sila nakikita-kita, may mga conferences, let's make it a point na magkaroon tayo ng census so that you could have a list of your catechists and catechetical directors. And for me, it's very interesting because we thought we would not get as high as 25,000. Now, we have as high as 28, 29,000 and counting. And so, I think where we get the feel, if I'm not mistaken, this probably will be about more than 50% of the catechists all over the country. Okay? Self-reported catechists. This is good. Now, this one, for the national report, you have to understand, and this clear to mga sampling problem ng mga
mga statistician, no? Alam nyo, very interesting. Kung gusto nyong magkaroon ng walang problema pag nag-research kayo at sinabi sa inyo na may problema ka, then how are you going to sample? Kung kaya mo mag-census, mag-census ka para wala ka ng problema sa sampling frame. Nagtignan nyo po ako. So, yung sabihin, kung yung population identify mo, kunin mo lahat para wala ng problema sa ano sa defense. Nagtignan nyo? So, ngayon, paano yung sampling frame? When we're finished with the 30,000 census, meaning you got the entire population, then you randomize the representation for each ecclesiastical province as a sampling frame to explain what's happening with the catechist. Entindihan niyo po ba? So, ibig sabihin, ang ginawa po namin ay kumuha po kami ng datos para makapag-sample kami for the national report. However, it is very, very exciting that because you have the census of each ecclesiastical territory, then you could actually share it to everyone so that each ecclesiastical territory can plan depending on their data. Now, what is the state of the responses of each ecclesiastical territory? Ito na, walang sisihan. Ito yung dumating sa amin. Kung hindi nakarating sa LBC, wala akong magagawa, hindi ko yung matitrace, right? Okay, so these are the seven discussion themes. So take note, ha, we're talking of information, catechetical ministry involvement, formation, both formal and ongoing, content and pedagogy, leadership for the leaders, and spiritual life and spiritual domains, no? So pareho siya, may pagkakaiba lang sa questions on leadership here, but we're looking at seven sections with 269 variables to work with. One variable for census cost 1 million pesos. Okay? For the Philippine Statistical Authority. So you could just imagine that we need a lot of prayers for the team para babaan talaga ng Espiritu Santo para ma-process namin to. It's a very, very powerful data set now. And sabi ko nga, I'm excited kasi I'm opening it up. The real science to this is you open it up to further critique by fellow academic. I'm open. Critique how we did it and look at the data. Look at how we code it so that you could produce your own analysis. Okay? So, medyo excited. So, ngayon, kung meron kayong mga estudyante na magsusunod, I was telling the conference last week, sabi ko yung conference participant, you know what? Stop writing something na hindi mapapakinabangan ng simbahan natin. Nalulungkot na ako sa mga defense na ang dami nagsusulat ng mga topic na hindi naman kailangan. Ang laking problema natin eh. May datos na tayo, gamitin mo yung datos, and then problematize it, and we're going to help you. Right? So, this is open to the seminaries and all the catechetical centers. If you want to do something good for the church, let it be a master's or a PhD on the basis na may basis na, right? Anyway, so, this is it. Okay. So, this is by ecclesiastical provinces. This is what I'm talking about. 27992, all in all. So we went through a series of data gathering given the fact that we did not realize the landscape. We thought that we will do online, hindi siya ganun ka-effective. Online. So therefore, wala mga internet ang mga katekista. May FB pero hindi marunong mag-Google Form. Yan ang problema. So, sabi sa amin, gumawa kayo ng questionnaire, ibibigay natin ng papel. Okay. So ito 18,000 papel lahat 'yan. Okay. Ang problema, pina-encode niyo naman sa akin yung papel na 'yan, right? Ang per encoding na po, this is so unjust. Please help me pray for those who encoded because they were only paid 5 pesos for the 10 pages of encoding material. And each page cost 7 pesos. Pero 5 pesos lang ang pambayad namin, right? But they were able to do it. Imagine kung binayaran mo yung 18,000.